Hi, once again we came with a new product from Advanced Technology, that is Biomedical Research Board. We are very glad to introduce this product to you. It mainly contains 8 body sensors on a single board, where you won't see this kind of product anywhere in the market on a single board. Okay, it has body temperature sensor, pulse oximeter, EMG, ECG, respiratory, blood pressure, body position sensor, and galvanic skin response. Okay, using body temperature, we can find out temperature, and by using EMG, we can find out the muscle strength. By using ECG, we can find out at what rate our heart is pumping the blood and at what rate it is releasing the blood. And respiratory, it tells about at what rate we are inhaling the air and at what rate we are exhaling the air. And blood pressure sensor, it tells about what is the systolysis and diastolysis and pulse rate of our heart. And body position sensor, it tells about at what angle we are at present, that maybe we are sitting or standing, or at what angle we are inclining. And galvanic skin response, it tells about the body resistance with respect to moisture which is created on the body. Now we will show you how our board can be interfaced with our computer. Let me tell you some other features which we are having on this board. We are having Bluetooth. Due to that Bluetooth, you can transmit the data wirelessly either to your cell phone or to your computer. It has Zigbee. Due to that facility, you can use this board as one of the end node in various places to get various body parameters wirelessly. It has Ethernet to have local server created so that we can monitor the patient remotely. And it has GSM. If you want to transmit the data through an SMS, we have GSM. All that we need to do is just press this particular button, and by pressing this particular button, it will send various sensor data on an SMS. Now we can clearly see on this particular software that blood pressure is around some 35 degrees, and now blood temperature is around some 35 degrees, and now it has increased up to 36, and it has it is between cold and normal. Now if I'm releasing this at some particular point of time, we will observe that the temperature decreases from that particular point and it goes to room temperature. Now let us see the plotting of that particular temperature sensor. Here you can clearly see on the waveform chart that our values are around some 35 degrees. On the gauze also you can clearly see that it is indicating at 35, and in this particular table we can clearly see that at 0 to 2 years normal temperature is between 36.4 to 38, and 3 to 10 years it is between 36.1 to 37.8, and between 11 to 15 it is from 35.9 to 37.6. And then now let us see the data logging. In this data logging, we converted the temperature into Celsius, Fahrenheit, and with respect to date and with respect to time, and what is the Celsius and what is the Fahrenheit, we have clearly got it in a table. If you want to save it, all that we need to do is just select the data which you want to save and right click and export to Excel. It forms an Excel sheet. If you want to take a printout, all that you need to do is go to that Excel sheet and take a printout. Thank you. Now let us see the demonstration of airflow sensor, or it is also called as a respiratory sensor. Using this sensor, we can find out the inhaling and exhaling of the air which is coming out of the nose. It is basically used for asthma patients, and not only in that case, there are a lot of applications of this.
Now if I'm inhaling the air, you can see that value is going up. And then if I'm exhaling, if I'm keeping at some distance, it is not having any value. And if I'm again inhaling, again we have seen that value. Okay, through that we can keep some threshold. Depending upon that threshold, we can easily find out whether that person has normal breathing or abnormal breathing. Because code is given to you, you can easily edit it. Thank you.
Okay, now we are going to introduce you to the body position sensor. Okay, this body position sensor will tell whether the patient is lying at what x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. We have calibrated either he is in flat position or he was in right position or left or bottom or down. Okay, you can clearly see all those values here. You can clearly see this is the x-axis value, this is y-axis value and z-axis value. Now that patient is flat. Okay, when I'm tilting down, it is telling it is landscape right. Okay, and when I'm tilting towards left, it is telling it is landscape left. And when I'm tilting towards up, it is telling he is standing up. And when I'm tilting it down, it is telling it is portrait down. Okay, from this we can clearly, not only using this, because code is available with you, you can write your own algorithm. And you can calibrate by your own, to have either it may be an angle or some other thing. Otherwise, because in serially x-axis, y-axis, z-axis values are available. If you want to take it into MATLAB or if you want to take it into LabVIEW, you can easily take it that values into LabVIEW. By using this, we can easily find out how actually a patient is at which particular position. Okay, now what I want to say is, with respect now all this various parameters, we are acquiring the data on the computer. So acquiring one at a time, it will give more resolution and more accuracy. But if you can acquire two or three sensors data at a time, and if you can write your own algorithm, you can have better results. Thank you.